if you will turn with me to 1 Corinthians 15, I'm going to go to verse 10. Doe has spoken this verse several times. God was ministering it to me this morning. It says, but by the grace of God, I am what I am. And then he goes on and he says, and his grace, which was bestowed upon me, was not in vain. But I labored more abundantly than they all. And look at this next phrase. He said, yet not I that labored, but the grace of God which was in me.
Amen.
If you look at that verse, you see that grace works. It labors. It labored in Paul, and it brought about Paul what Paul needed to do and what Paul needed to be. That grace worked. You could say that the definition of grace then was an undeserved working. Because it worked in Paul, he didn't deserve it, but because of it, because it was working, Paul labored more than they all. And what did he say with it? I am what I am. I am what God made me to be. That's what the labor, that's what the grace did in Paul. It worked. You know, if you think about Zerubbabel, he said grace, grace, grace to the mountain. And you know what? There was a work done.
Amen.
There was a work done, an undeserved work. And what was the work? The mountain became a plain.
Amen.
It became a plain. Look at with me to Acts 11:21. It says 21, then Peter went down. Let me see, make sure I've got the right, I've got the wrong page here. Here, 21. And the hand of the Lord was with them, and a great number believed and turned unto the Lord. And look at verse 22. It said, then tidings of these things came into the ears of the church was at Jerusalem, and they sent forth Barnabas that he should go as far as Antioch. They sent Barnabas. They said, they hear stuff. So what did Barnabas do? He said, who, when Barnabas came, had seen the grace of God. He saw the grace of God working. It was working in these people, in Cyprus and Cyrenius and Antioch. It was a grace working. It was an undeserved working. And what did it bring about? Many that believed. Many that believed. Now, go with me to 2 Corinthians 12. 2 Corinthians 12, verse 7. Let's see. Yeah. 2 Corinthians 11. Then I should be exalted above measure through the abundance of the revelations. This is Paul talking. He had a spirit, that a messenger from Satan to buffet him.
Amen.
To buffet him. Paul was in, it says, lest I should be exalted above measure. And then he says, for this thing I besought the Lord thrice that it might depart from me. Paul had a situation that he didn't like, that he was in, and he had Satan was up against him. Satan was coming after him. And what did he do? He prayed to God. He said, get this thing off of me. Get this thing off of me. Get me out of here. I am in a situation and I want out of it. And what did God tell him? He said unto me, my grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. There was a work that God was doing here in Paul with this buffeting, with this situation. And he said, you know what? My grace is sufficient for me. That working, that undeserved working is enough for you, Paul, to work in this. The undeserved working is enough for you, Paul, to work in this. Why? And he goes on, he says, because my strength is made perfect in weakness. What was God doing? He had Paul in a weakness so that God could strengthen him.
Amen.
So that God could strengthen him. You're in a situation? And I want to go to one more thing. I want you to go to Ephesians 4. And I'm going to go to, let me see if I can, I lost it here. Oh, yeah. There. It says, verse 6, one God and Father of all, who is above all, through all, and in you all. But look at this. It says, unto every one of us is given grace
Amen.
According to the measure of the gift of Christ.
Amen.
You know what a wonderful verse that is? Whatever God sets you in, whatever he has intended you to be, whatever God has you to do, he has given you enough grace to do it.
Amen.
Enough undeserving working to make sure that it comes to pass. Undeserved working The only thing you have to do is keep your faith in it. It says, by grace we are saved through faith. Your faith is necessary, but the grace is working right along with that faith to get it, to get the job done. One of my favorite stories, and one that I remind myself often of, is John Newton, the man that wrote Amazing Grace. Because he was a young man. His mother died when he was 7. His father was a merchant marine. He went to ship with his father for several voyages, and then his father retired. He stayed and became a merchant marine. Well, back in the early 1700s, they had what we call, we call it the draft. Well, if England wanted you in the Navy, they just came and got you and stuck you on a ship. There was no such, it was called impressing. They picked you up and put you in the Navy. You had no say. Well, they did that to John Newton. And he became, he worked on a ship. He tried to escape. They brought him back. They flogged him in front of 350 men. They disgraced him. They humiliated him. They put him down to nothing. And then he went to a slave ship. He worked on a slave ship. He eventually became a slave captain. And John Newton said he became more vile than anybody he had known. That's how bad it was. More vile. And he ended up becoming a slave for another ship captain and his wife. He almost starved to death. And then another captain recognized who he was. He recognized he was the son of his father. And he brought him out. He got him to escape. And he rescued him. And they put him on a ship. Well, that ship ended up in terrific peril. And they thought that they were going to lose the ship altogether. And John Newton told the captain, he said, if God doesn't have mercy on us, we're all dead. We're all dead. And this is from a man that said he was more vile than anybody else he ever knew. But you know what happened? He said he ended up captaining the ship. He had the rudder. He was steering the ship for 11 hours during the storm. And John Newton shares. He said he started the most vile person you'd ever met. And that grace, he said, worked on him for 11 hours. He couldn't move. He had to stay at the stern. He had to steer the ship through the storm. So for 11 hours, he said, that grace worked on him. It worked on him. And at the end of the 11 hours, the man was born again. And he ended up becoming a preacher. 11 hours, grace, undeserving work, worked on that man and got him into the position that God wanted him in. And he ended up writing Amazing Grace. What a beautiful hymn, the most popular hymn of all time. Why? Because of 11 hours of walking, putting through that grace. Whatever job God has us to do, the grace is sufficient enough to get us through it if we will use our faith, if we will stand with it, work with it, and use our faith. Amen.